Almost everyone already experienced leg cramps in their life. Cramps are sudden pain and tightness in the muscles, usually the calf muscles behind the leg, but can also happen in front of the leg, in the thigh, or in the foot. In this video, I will explain what causes muscle cramps, how to treat them when they happen, and how to prevent them. So, let's talk about muscle cramps today. In North America, muscle cramps are also known as Charley horses, and in Europe, as choppers. These are painful contractions of a muscle, usually the calves, hamstrings, or the foot. What causes muscle cramps? In the past, people thought that cramps were caused by dehydration and depletion of electrolytes. However, recent scientific studies could not demonstrate these theories. The exact mechanism is still unknown, but there seems to be an imbalance between contraction and relaxation of the muscle fibers, which is called the altered neuromuscular control theory. That's why all cramps are relieved by stretching of the muscles. At the end of this video, I will demonstrate how to stretch the muscles. There are basically six types of cramps: pregnancy-related, neurogenic muscle cramps, muscle cramps associated with a medical condition, exercise-associated muscle cramps that are side effects of medications, and the last one is idiopathic leg cramps or nocturnal leg cramps. First, pregnancy-related cramps are very common either before or after delivery. It seems that the main causes are depletion of magnesium and dehydration. In this case, the supplementation with magnesium is helpful to reduce the frequency and intensity of cramps. Stretching of the muscles also helps to prevent and alleviate an episode of leg cramp that is associated with pregnancy. Second, neurogenic muscle cramps are painful muscle contractions that occur in people with neurological diseases. They are caused by a problem of the neurons coordinating the contractions of the muscles. For example, cramps occur in approximately 50% of patients with ALS, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, 64% of patients with polyneuropathy, and 80% of Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease. Cramps are also very common in people with Parkinson's disease, stroke, multiple sclerosis, spinal stenosis, carpal tunnel syndrome, and radiculopathy. For neurogenic cramps, in addition to regular stretching, there are some medications that can be prescribed by a physician. They include quinine sulfate, vitamin B complex, diltiazem, and nafrinil oxalate. It is important to consult a physician before taking any medication for cramps. Quinine has been associated with severe complications of lowering the platelet levels and is no longer available as a supplement that can be obtained without a doctor's prescription in the United States. Third, there are some medical conditions that predispose the person to have more leg cramps. Examples are liver cirrhosis caused by alcohol or hepatitis C, people on dialysis due to kidney failure, people with magnesium and calcium deficiencies, dehydration, diabetes, parathyroid or thyroid dysfunction, and varicose veins. In these cases, the most effective way to avoid cramps is by treating the underlying medical condition. Fourth is exercise-associated muscle cramps. These are muscle cramps after strenuous exercises, especially after a period of inactivity. They usually last 1 to 3 minutes and generally occur in the thigh or leg. It is important to visit a physician to make sure that there is no underlying metabolic, neurological, or endocrine disease. There are a few things that can be done to prevent exercise-associated muscle cramps. Stretching prior to exercise. Remember that stretching is the most effective way to get rid of an episode of cramps. 2. Despite the lack of empirical evidence, replacement of electrolytes is very common among athletes, mainly potassium. It is recommended to use nutritional options like drinks and food rich in potassium. Here, are the top 10 sources of potassium. Dried apricots, cooked lentils, dried prunes, acorn squash, raisins, flesh of baked potato, kidney beans, orange juice, mature seeds of soybeans, and banana. How much potassium does a person need per day? Female adults need 2600 milligrams per day. During pregnancy and lactation, this increased to 2900 per day. And male adults need 3400 milligrams per day. There are some conditions that put a person at higher risk of potassium deficiency, such as people with inflammatory bowel diseases and those who use certain medications like diuretics and laxatives. Third, massage. Massage immediately before an event could reduce the number of cramps. However, this has not been demonstrated in rigorous studies yet. Four, neuromuscular re-education to correct any muscular imbalances. There is an interesting study showing that hamstring cramps can be avoided if the person does exercises for strengthening and re-education of the gluteus maximus muscles. Fifth, there are other interesting treatments for exercise-induced cramps that showed some promising initial results in scientific studies. One of them is drinking pickle juice when the cramps started. It seems that the duration of the cramps were diminished. And last, there is some suggestion that hyperventilation strategies work to reduce the duration of an exercise-associated muscle cramp. The person is instructed to breathe quickly and deeply, 20 to 30 deep breaths per minute when the cramp starts. The fifth cause of muscle cramps can be side effects of prescribed medications. Statins, for example, these are medications to lower cholesterol, such as atorvastatin, fluvastatin, lovastatin, pravastatin, rosuvastatin, or simvastatin. Diuretics to lower blood pressure, the water pills, such as furosemide and hydrochlorothiazide. Alzheimer's disease medication like donepezil. And nifedipine, a treatment for angina and high blood pressure. Raloxifene is an osteoporotic treatment. And some asthma medications like terbutaline and albuterol. Also some Parkinson's disease medication, tocopone, opioids like morphine, and some antibiotics, antiretrovirals, anti-cancer, and antipsychotic drugs. Sixth and last, when we can't find a cause or precipitating factor for muscle cramps, we call this just idiopathic muscle cramps or nocturnal leg cramps. They are more common in older age. Approximately one-third of individuals over the age of 50 years have regular nocturnal leg cramps. It seems that these cramps are associated with shortened muscle length and less physical activity. The only treatment that we know for idiopathic leg cramps is stretching. We recommend the person to stretch before going to bed and when the leg cramp occurs. Another thing that is very helpful to reduce the pain is to walk a few steps before stretching. Walking is excellent to get rid of cramps. However, there are situations that walking is not possible, like if the person is driving a car or swimming. These situations can be very dangerous. The person who is prone to muscle cramps needs to stretch the muscles before driving or swimming to avoid any unexpected cramp. So for this stretching exercise, all you need is a wall. Just stay maybe 2 feet from the wall. And the affected leg, you're going to support your affected foot on the wall. And then you're going to move your body forward, your hips forward. Keep your both knees straight. And you notice that if you just keep putting your hips forward, you're stretching. I'm feeling the stretch on the calf muscles of this right foot. And then you can do with the other one. Just put the left one there. Knees straight. It's really important to keep the knees straight. And just move your hips forward. And you'll be noticing. So if you do this in the middle of the night, when you have those leg cramps, You all walk first before you do this. Just sometimes just by walking, you will notice that the cramps are going away. And then you find a wall and just do this exercise. This is the stretching of the calf muscles. If the cramps happen when you are sleeping, you are in bed, and you just want to stretch in bed, you can try to do this by yourself. Keep the knees straight and try to pull the toes towards your face. Just by doing this, you may alleviate. You can also try doing this. You can also try to help with your hands, pulling this way, if the cramps are happening here in the calf. But sometimes if the cramps are happening here in the front of the leg, you need to do the opposite. You need to pull down, 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 to stretch the muscle that is having the cramps. And sometimes the cramps happen inside of the foot. So then you need to stretch the muscles inside of your foot. So you can do this or this. And if you want to do more efficiently, you can leave a bed sheet on the side of your bed. And if they are happening in the middle of the night, you can just pull and do the stretch like this, because then you'll be stretching the whole foot and leg and calf. Just keep the knees straight. The important thing is to keep the knees straight when you are stretching the leg calf muscles. Please share this video with anyone that you know has muscle cramps and need to hear about these instructions. In the comments below, write down if you have leg cramps and which strategies works best for you. Please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, if you have regular muscle cramps, if you take medications, please talk to your doctor. And if there is any emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.